Hello everyone. In my previous video, we have seen how to compute eigenvalues and various properties of eigenvalues and eigenvectors. This video is a continuation of that. Here we will see how to compute eigenvectors. So the very first step is in finding the eigenvectors is we have to consider the matrix equation A minus lambda I x equal to 0, where x is a column matrix x, y, z. And your lambda is the eigenvalues that we have computed earlier. So if we have got three different eigenvalues, substitute the values of lambda over here, solve the equation, matrix equation, and to get the various values of x, y, z, the final answer of x, y, z are your eigenvectors. So let us see the cases for finding the eigenvectors. Type 1, where eigenvectors are non-repeated. That means if we have three different eigenvalues and we have to get three different eigenvectors. Let us say that the first eigenvalue is 1. We have to substitute in the following equation as seen earlier, A minus lambda I x equal to 0. Where lambda is your first eigenvalue, that is substitute 1 over here. A is the matrix given to me. I is the identity matrix. And x we have considered as x, y, z as a column matrix. Then we'll get a matrix, augment the matrix, reduce to canonical form and find the solution of x, y, z, or you can solve this matrix by Cramer's rule to get the answers of x, y, z. Similarly, we get for a different eigenvalue, we get the different eigenvector. Similarly, for the third eigenvalue, I'll get the third eigenvector. So this is a case when I have lambda as one number, I get x1. Corresponding to second eigenvalue, I get second eigenvector. And corresponding to third eigenvalue, I get third eigenvector. So there are two ways for solving these matrices. One is you get augment the matrix, reduce it to canonical form and find the solution. Or directly you can solve the values of x, y, z by Cramer's rule. Type 2, where eigenvectors are repeated. Now, if the eigenvectors are repeated, that in the case, some problems we can have a single eigenvector. In some problems, we can have two eigenvectors. In some problems, we can have three eigenvectors. So, basically, how to check whether the matrix has single eigenvector or two eigenvectors or three eigenvectors. Now, this case appears when we get a non-repeated eigenvalue. If we get a non-repeated eigenvalue, we have seen earlier, augment the matrix, reduce to canonical form and find the solution. But if now the eigenvalues is repeated, that means earlier case I had considered 1, 2, 3 as eigenvalue. Now I will consider as 1, 1, 2. That means 1 is repeated. In this case, first procedure is you check whether the matrix is symmetric or non-symmetric. If the matrix is non-symmetric, then simple, the procedure is augment the matrix, reduce it to canonical form, find the rank of the matrix, or also what you can do is find the solution by Cramer's rule. But now we have to check whether the eigenvector is repeated or non-repeated. So in this case, if the rank is 2, then it has only one eigenvector. That means now if the matrix is non-symmetric, you get a augmented matrix, reduce it to canonical form and find the rank. If that reduced matrix rank is 2 and it is a 3 by 3 matrix, then it has only one eigenvector. That means you won't have 3 eigenvectors as your final answer, you will have only 2 eigenvectors. Whereas if the rank is 1, then it will have 2 eigenvectors, that means total answer that will be 3. How to find the single eigenvector? Put z as t and find x and y, or you vice versa. But if x2 is not equal to x3, that means we'll have 3 different eigenvectors. If in x2 you put z as t, for x3 you have to alternate the substitution. That means put x is equal to t or y is equal to t and so on. So we are linearly dependent. That means we have two different eigenvectors in this case, but in this case we'll have only one eigenvector. But now this won't work if the matrix is symmetric. If the matrix is symmetric, then to find
the reduce the matrix into canonical form, we'll have the first matrix that I get is ZST and Y0, find X2, that is okay. But now for the third eigenvector, we won't have to alternate as we did in this case. We have to assume element method. Now what is element method? Assume the eigenvector as the column vector element. And then we know that these are X1 transpose X3 and X2 transpose X3. That means we have to we'll get two equations in form of L, M and N. Solve these two equations by Cramer's rule to get the answers of element. These answers of element is the third eigenvector. So by Cramer's rule we can find element, that is my final answer. Now this was the basic of your eigenvector. Now there are few examples that you can solve by computing. So take down these examples, solve them and compute the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of all the four examples. I hope you have understood. Thank you for watching.